Hello and welcome to part 2 of the platforming kit tutorial series. In this part, I'll show you how to add your own characters, complete with importing spreadsheets and converting them and transforming them into sprites and then into animation. Here we already have a spreadsheet got from the internet. I'll put the link in the description. What we did is just imported it into Unreal, and now in order to make it fine for pixel art, this is only done for pixel art spreadsheets, so if you have other more HD spreadsheets don't, you right click it, then we go into sprite actions. And then we apply paper to the texture setting, so this removes the anti-aliasing from the games and makes the texture crisp and nice looking. So the next part is we right click it and press extract sprites. Now Unreal does an automated type of sprite selection. Sometimes it's okay, but this time we'll use grid because we know our exact dimensions for the sprites. They should be 100 pixels by 80 pixels. If we leave them like this, some errors will pop, will appear. Okay, so we change it to 100 by 80. Now you can see that they're all nice and squared-ish, and now we press the extract button. This is gonna take a while since it's gonna divide our spreadsheet into different sprites and extract them as individual components. So you can open up any, you can make any spreadsheets, any PNG with a transparent background. So here we have our extracted sprites, which you can see are nice looking, and they're ready to be transformed into animations. Here, this is something I already did before starting the video, but we'll just delete this. Just take the sprites out of the textures folder. You can leave them there, but I recommend you have everything in one place and move them to a folder inside the sprites, into a subfolder inside the sprites folder. Okay, so we'll just select them all. We have a lot of dwarves at our disposal, but we're only gonna use the red one for now, since it's just for tutorial purposes. Okay. There you go, we just drag and drop the move. Yeah, there are a lot of sprites, there are like around 200 or so sprites, but as I said, we won't use them all. Okay, now that that's done, creating a flipbook animation is as easy as selecting the sprites that we want. Now we're gonna make the idle animation. We selected our four sprites and then press create flipbook. You can do this with any number of sprites. Now let's name it to dwarf idle. And as you can see, the flipbook is created and the animation is working. Let's just put it to 10 frames per second, so it's a bit slower. This is how we do it for every animation we want to create. Now we're gonna create the move animation. We'll select all the movement sprites, create flickbook, name it, and voila. It's very easy to do. Again, we'll just set the speed to 10, so it's a bit slower. Okay, and for purposes of this tutorial, we'll only create two more animations because these flipbooks don't have all the animations our original character has. We'll make the dwarf attack animation. See, this is him attacking. Okay, save it to move it to 10 seconds. And the next one will just add the generic, the default animations for falling and jumping. So you can create animations out of one sprite as well. It doesn't matter. I'll just call it both fall. As you can see, it's just one sprite, so nothing spectacular. And now you go to the blueprints, you go to the player character. Okay, selected. So here is the sprite. The sprite selected. Just scroll down until we found the dwarf island. Is a bit off center. Let's just move him here. And okay. And we'll flip him. So you just have to make sure that he's in the default position. So he over the collision overlaps the sprite. And he doesn't overlap the blocking collision. And so on. It's a bit of work, but nothing too extraordinary. So now let's just modify the collision a bit. Okay, I'm trying to select this, but it doesn't seem movable, probably because it's the default object, but that's okay. We'll just move the sprite a bit inside, and we'll move the shield. So these are freely movable, of course, no problem. That's the combat text position. This is something that you'll see in the future version of the pack. But now, once you've settled that, you just go to the animation tab. Now, for the flipbook idle, we're gonna select the dwarf idle. For the flipbook walk, we're gonna select the dwarf move. Now we have transitional animations for mostly everything, but if you don't have it, just clear it, put it to none, and then it will automatically skip, so it's no problem. So we don't have any transitional animations, just clear it. Okay, flipbook jump, let's just put the fall animation, flipbook fall, and again just the flipbook fall, flipbook fall, and just clear. And the attack, we'll just do the melee attack for now, since it's self-explanatory. Where's the melee attack? Where did I put it? Let's save it. I think I said, there you go. Okay, that's all. Just compile it to see everything is in order. Save it. And now, voila, we can move our dwarf. See, here is the idle animation, here is the moving animation. So it works fairly simple. Just moving back and forth. Now the attack animation, see, everything works, that's fine. The jump animation, so that's good. So it's very easy to add your own custom sprites to the pack. Now, if you see here, since we only modified a few of the animations, some of the old ones remain. So, for example, see, if I'm doing this, the sprites from the old character will remain. But if you edit your character and add custom animations for everything, then everything will be alright. So, this is the end of part 2. See you in part 3.